that would be the employees. So any employee who uses computer, which means everyone.
Hi everyone, today Lisa is here. He's a security engineer at ExpressVPN. We will ask him what security engineer does and how to become a security engineer. So Lisa, thank you very much for joining us today.
My pleasure.
So Lisan, could you tell us your career background?
All right. So I'm currently a security engineer in ExpressVPN. I previously also in ExpressVPN, but was from a different role. I was working as the automation engineer. Before that, I was working in a company called Horangi. They make cybersecurity product. So I was part of the DevOps engineering team that take care of the infrastructure for the product itself.
I see. Thank you very much. Okay, so Lisan, could you tell us about your company?
Sure. So our company is actually a VPN company. So our goal and our product is actually to protect the privacy and security of our users.
I see. Okay. What is the scope of your job responsibility?
For my job itself, we are part of a larger security team. So the whole team, we were looking after the security posture of the whole company, including the products and also the internal employees. For me specifically, we are the security engineering team. So we focus more on the security tooling, assisting our other team within security, such as the offensive security team and also the threat hunting team with their integration and automation requirement.
Okay. So how many people working at your team?
For the whole security team, we have about 26.
26 people?
Yeah.
All right, thank you. So next question is, who are the stakeholders internally and externally?
So internally, we have three different kind of stakeholders. I'll group them in three. So first, we have the software engineering team. For this team, we were helping them to improve the security of our product and also to keep our customers safe. For the second part of it, that would be the employees. So any employee who uses computer, which means everyone. We have to keep all our employees safe when they do the work. Then lastly would be the security team. So the security team itself, we own some of the security processes and the tools that we are looking after. So that is the stakeholder itself. As for outside, so we have auditors and vendor. For auditors, they help to ensure that we are always on top of our compliance requirement. As for vendor, they provide services for a lot of the internal security usage.
I see. All right, thank you. What is the biggest challenge you have met so far in this role?
This is something a bit not as traditional in terms of a cybersecurity engineering space. For us here in ExpressVPN, we're also looking after our physical security. It is as important as our online security. So we need to protect the office space. We need to make sure that no one comes in and take our laptops, you know, our internal data and stuff like that. This is non-traditional because it's physical security. And this is a challenge because physical security setup is very traditional itself. You know, there's no online capability for your alarm or for your door access, and there's no remote monitoring, right? So this is a big challenge because we wouldn't know something went wrong until we are physically there, because it's a physical security itself. It took us a while to resolve, but we had to come up with some very creative solution to actually integrate the whole thing and overcome this problem and this requirement that we have. Additionally, why this is a challenge? Because we have a more modern work culture whereby we have flexible hours. Someone can come in early or they can come in late and they can leave late. So it's very unlike a traditional office where you have a fixed working hours. Because of this, our security, we cannot just lock the office down from what time to what time. So because of that, we need to have all kind of more flexible solution where we can integrate with online system where we can actually ensure the security while we can monitor and also we can manage them remotely.
I see. How did you overcome the challenges?
Okay, so since this is a less traditional problem in the security engineering space, so we have to come up with our own custom solution to actually overcome this problem. So we actually develop in-house circuit board to communicate between the physical security system with our online system. And then we also integrate the online system with our existing chat or messaging system, whereby we can actually monitor and we can see or we can discuss about various activity that happens in the physical security space. That involves a number of software and integration that we are using, and also automation tools. I would like to highlight that I'm quite appreciative of our company and also our manager to allow us to actually try something to challenge the status quo. We were allowed to explore what is outside of our typical job description. We can do something that is beyond. We were allowed to try something or to do something beyond, eventually help to solve the problem in an elegant way. Yes.
I see. All right. Thank you very much. And the final question is, what is the motivation?
Personally, for me, I actually enjoy solving problems. Whenever I complete a task or a project, it feels like I just crack a safe. You know, like there's a sense of achievement. And additionally, seeing that all our users, internal, external, they are safer with our security control that we implemented, I think that gives me the satisfaction. I can give an example. Recently, we were able to detect and contain a malware that accidentally downloaded by one of our employees. The detection was done through our EDR system, and then the containment happened almost immediately. After our investigation, we found out that there was no data being exfiltrated. We were quite happy with this. So the malware came in through a phishing email. Although we weren't able to block all the phishing email that is possible to come in, right, because there's so many variants. But with this additional layer of security control, actually helped us to catch this. So I think this is this speaks of having layers of security control that is very helpful in terms of protecting our users inside or outside.
I see. All right. Thank you very much. So in the next episode, we will talk about how to get this position and its career path.